Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome. Welcome to the infamous Closet of Truth, where you have questions and I have answers. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. As you can tell, we are entering uncharted territory as it relates to what is going on in the world of politics. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, they have labeled Zeus the boogeyman of sorts. Good morning or good afternoon, Fourth Sister. Good morning or good afternoon, Fired Up. And Janene, greetings. Yes, they have labeled Zeus the villain out here. And I wanted to get into that a little bit. Am I as bad as they say? Yes, it is I, Triple H. Am I as bad as they say? Oh my God. Oh my goodness. You know, a lot of people, they're haters. Are they? Is my messaging, is it too harsh? Those of you out there who know what I do, I build my brand on trust, you know, honesty, and accountability, okay? You know, I create content, okay? And these people, they say, good afternoon, Christina. I create amazing content, some of the most critical content out there about the former president. Jan, cut it out. And yet, I still have my friends on the right. They go, Zeus is so mean to us. He blocks us. This is what they say. And you're darn right I'll block you. If you get into my live and you want to talk about everything other than what we're talking about and you get into the insulting business, I just got to block you. A lot of you, you know what I've built my platform on. Honesty and integrity and respect. I respect everyone. I may talk about the individual in terms of their policies. I may talk about the individual's stance on issues, but I do not stand for talking about people. No, it's just bad. You know why? And I got a song, you know, that people need to hear. Because, you know, this morning I played, you know, those taps, right? Because, you know, I got sound bites for all of this stuff. Good morning, Blazing Grizzly. See, a lot of people don't understand. I'm rehabilitated. I've done a lot of work on myself, and when I feel like I need to go there, you know, we need to get, you know, real toxic, I have to dial, wait a second, Zeus, that's not what this is about, okay, but, you know, so I don't go there, but I have a song, care to listen to it, that kind of describes how I am feeling right now, because I think a lot of people have forgotten about Zeus and where I came from. Maybe this will remind you. Yeah. Yeah. This is dedicated to the Trump supporters that seem to have forgotten about Zeus.
Y'all know me, still the same OG, but I've been low key.
That's right.
Go on by most these niggas with no deals and no G's, no wheels and no keys, no ghosts, no more bills and no skis.
Yeah.
Mad at me because I can finally afford.
I'm just trying to provide groceries to my family. That's all.
To add to the wall full of plaques, hanging up in the office, yeah. Back of my house like trophies. Did y'all think I'ma let my dough?
You think I'ma let my dough freeze? No. Yeah, who taught you all this stuff on TikTok? Who taught you? It was Zeus. And when your TikTok lives weren't doing so good, who's the doctor they told you to go see?
Who's the doctor they told you to go see? Y'all better listen up closely.
They said I turned pop, ladies and gentlemen.
So fuck y'all, all of y'all. If y'all don't like me, blow me.
If you don't like Zeus,
turn me back to the old.
Uh oh. Nowadays, everybody wanna talk like they got something to say, but nothing comes out. What are they saying about me? What do they got to say? That's right. To study his paper in WA. One day I was walking by when I was going to go. Hey! Slim Shady! Hot in here. Crazy. Now, Dave, everybody, what's wrong? What are they saying? Welcome to the closet of truth. These folks, ladies and gentlemen, want to get all up in Zeus's live. And talk about Zeus like they don't know who Zeus is. God of sky and thunder, Triple H, the most handsome in the kingdom. Okay, what really I gotta talk about today, this is important. So you got Trump supporters going around saying President Joe Biden, and by the way, God bless President Joe Biden. He's insulting us. He's insulting us. When he calls us MAGA. Why are you insulted that Biden is referring to you by the title you love to be on social media bragging about? Is there anything wrong with MAGA that I don't know about? You should be honored that he's calling you by the title that your leader has designated for you. Next thing you know, well, I don't like what I hear these Democrats saying about us. They're mean. Have you heard what the MAGA, the Trump supporters, have said about the Democrats? Ladies and gentlemen, you can't get out here and cry that the game's not fair when you yourself aren't even playing by the rules, okay? And then try to act like we don't see it for what it is, which is hypocrisy. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, you have Donald J. Trump. I'm going to open up the box because this is the closet of truth, but I got to let you know where the issue is. You have a former president who's being charged with 34 felonies up in the state of New York, and you're still supporting this guy. You're still branding yourself as MAGA. And then when we call you MAGA and tell you you're supporting, I'm ashamed. I'm offended. Spare me the outrage. It makes no sense. Right now, this is also what got me excited today, or I should say upset. Going through my news feed, they got this E. Jean Carroll thing going on today. The trial's going down. Trump didn't show up. Headline blasts across. It says, she started out the trial today. This is how she started out the trial. She said, I am here because Donald J. Trump graped me. What? This is how she started her trial. And I've been sending this link to all of my friends on the right. Check this out. Check this out. This is how this woman started off the defamation case with an account of Donald Trump sexually SA-ing her in on the sixth floor of a department store. Whether I don't know what to think of it other than, you know, assuming this is true, it blows my mind. It really does that he can still have people out here supporting him. If you support Donald Trump with 34 felonies, okay, you support Donald Trump with women left and right accusing him of this SA stuff, you support Donald Trump still as after we've went through and we've talked about who's responsible for the attack on the Capitol on January 6th, which is Donald Trump. We talked about the big lie. Who told you the election was stolen and that Biden didn't win? Donald Trump. Who is the one that got Fox News in financial hell right now? Donald Trump. Who's the one that we got Ted Cruz? We got Ted Cruz now under Jack Smith's radar. Who's the one that's doing Donald Trump? We got a new possible grand jury trial out there in Michigan. More evidence between Michigan and Atlanta, Georgia. You got Trump once again. He's trying to steal voting machines. Greetings, Brother Gray. You got this one individual linked to so many crimes. And on top of that, he could possibly be an asset for Russia. If you are offended because we call you MAGA, then I think it's safe to say It's time to abandon the MAGA way. Get off of the ship. I just posted a video. This Republican out there. Well, tell us why you want Trump to be president. Well, Trump has done so much better when it comes to foreign policy. He had the economy in tip-top condition. I just felt a lot safer. There's just no way I would let Ron DeSantis get into office because I just don't trust Ron. Okay, so you don't trust Ron DeSantis. You don't trust Biden. The only person that you think could help get this country back on track is President, the former president, President Trump. And your logic, life was better when he was in office. No, it wasn't. I'm here to let you know, as a person, I voted blue, okay? And normally, we don't talk politics, okay? It's never before where I had to actually get out here, get on social media, and actually share with people the truth like this. But if it's something that needs to be done, I am committed to doing it. I talk to members of whatever party they're on. That's not an issue for me. I get along with a lot of great people. The only issue that I have that I'm seem to be kind of trying to wrap my mind around right now is you're ashamed of being a MAGA. You don't want us to call you MAGA, but you want to turn around and refer to Democrats as Democrats. That's what they say. The radical left. What else do they got? The Biden regime. It's okay for you to say those things. But the moment we say you're a Trump supporter, you get upset. Come on, folks. Like I said before, cut it out. I am a grown man out here. I'm a grown man. And I do not have time to be playing no kid games. And what are kid games? Kid games are you get in here. Fine, come talk to me. I'm nice. But I'm very critical. And if you got some new information, by all means, I'll consider it. But do not try to sit out here and say that I'm insulting you. No, I may be talking about the policies that you're talking. I might be talking about the content that you're trying to push in terms of it being misinformation. But I don't talk about you. I don't know you. Okay? And the kid games, ladies and gentlemen, they really do need to stop. Okay? I don't got time to be arguing with children on TikTok. My lives, they're for adults, 18 and over. I put the setting on there, okay? You can't just get out here and change the topic. That's not what I do. No. In the world that I live in, we're talking about one issue. Let's talk about it. Don't get in here and start talking about 10 different issues and then try to, oh, I got you, Zeus. I got you. You don't got me. No. Let me open up these boxes and see who I can talk to this morning. Because there's a lot of people need to be heard in the closet of truth. Good evening, brother Swervin. We meet again.
I was about to say, man, two times in one day. How could Absolutely. I be so lucky to be on a Mount Olympus twice in one day?
Absolutely.
This is like being in a Disney castle twice in one day.
It is.
Speaking of which, have you heard that Disney just filed a lawsuit against Ron DeSantis?
Oh, really? I did hear about that.
Yes, sir.
And again, another off the focus conduct going on with the Republican Party. Now you're suing Disney. As much as I have issues with that company, this is a waste of your time. I thought you were about helping the American people. How does this help?
Well, what I find very hypocritical.
Yeah.
Especially of Ron DeSantis. It is government should not be involved in business. Right? But I remember when he signed an executive order telling restaurants and small businesses, if you have a mask mandate, you will be fined $500 a day. That's what he said to small business.
Wow. Right? Yeah.
Then he comes out with the Don't Say Gay bill.
Mm-hmm.
Even though their biggest argument, nowhere in that bill does it says the word gay. Yeah, see, people like us, we know how to read between the lines.
Yeah.
We know exactly what it says. And so Disney, being the largest employer in the state of Florida, with Disney, if I recall reading by Disney's estimate, I think 37 to 44% of their entire staff are members of the LGBTQI+ community.
Oh.
So Disney spoke up.
Yeah.
They said, hey, You're disenfranchising our own employees. And if they decide to leave the state, guess what? We're going to be screwed. We can't replace them that fast.
That's a shame.
And the second Disney did that, next thing you know, Ron DeSantis wants to take away the Reedy Creek District. He's talking about building prisons. I mean, think for one moment. What sense does that make? We have the largest theme park in the world right here in Florida with all kinds of kids and senior citizens close by. Right. Let's stick a prison right outside of it.
It doesn't sound like he cares about kids. That's what it sounds like to me. Right.
He don't care about nobody but his own political ambition. Mm. And he ain't going to be able to run for president unless they change the law, ooh, which he's trying to get them to do right now. There's a law that says he has to be free of governorship for at least 10 days before he can declare his run for presidency.
Oh, so he's trying to get fired. Is that what you're suggesting?
Well, no, it's not that he's trying to get fired. He's trying to get them to change the law so he can go ahead and get into the race. In which sooner or later, they just may do it. But at that point, if you don't see the hypocrisy in the democracy of the Republican Party, I don't know what to tell you. I don't know what to tell you. The only thing I can tell you is keep sending them your money and see how that works out for you. Because we already send them our taxes, right?
I guess so.
Why would I send them any more money?
Because you love Donald J. Trump and the Republican Party, perhaps.
Come on, you already know better, kid. Come on, Zeus. You know me better than that.
I'm being sarcastic. I can't make it make sense. I don't understand why they're sending Trump their money. You know, I don't have the answers at the moment.
I've always said the only support Joe Biden needed from us was our vote. That was it.
That's it.
That was the only support. I didn't need to go and buy a Biden 2024 Speedo.
No, you don't need to do all of that. I mean, it's not that difficult, folks. Just listen to what they're saying and look at what they're doing. And if they don't align, they're lying. Simple. You know, Swervin, this is all, but now I want to ask you another question, because, you know, you have a lot of experience with this. Why do you think some of these friends of ours on the right, why do you think that they get upset when you refer to them as Trump supporters?
Well, it's not only Trump supporters. One of the things we've been seeing a lot of here lately, especially over the past year, when they do get into the box with us, they will sit there and go, you know, I'm more of a middle of the road kind of person. Mm-hmm. I don't lean left. I don't really lean right. I'm an independent. We got two wings on the same bird, two sides of the same coin.
I heard that.
And I think it's because they are embarrassed of the show.
Oh,
the reality show that they have turned the Republican Party into right now. But then at the end of all of that, they will tell you, I did vote for Donald Trump. He was a businessman.
Right.
Well, I got news for you. Donald Trump tried running as a Democrat twice. He tried running for president twice as a Democrat. And then he changed to Republican because he knew Democrats were not going to fall for his garbage.
Mm. It's the hammer of truth, by the way. It's hammer of truth, not hammer of lies.
Yeah, that's a fact. You can look that up. Okay, so in my mind,
I do know he was running as a Democrat before, and he realized the Democrats in general were just not going to support the type of brand of content politics he wanted to make. So he went and tried it on the Republican Party, and it worked out just well. I get that.
He basically said Republicans will believe anything you tell them.
Is that true to the Trump supporters here? Is this true, what I'm hearing from Brother Swervin? Is this true?
He also said, Zeus, and mm-hmm, I quote, the economy runs better. It always seems to do much better under Democrats. I don't know why, but it does. End quote. Mm-hmm. And I don't know. I'm sure you're aware of the economic situation we have looming right now with the debt ceiling.
I hear the Republican Party, led by Kevin McCarthy, has put together a very strong budget that, you know, Biden just needs to approve along with some other Republicans. What are your thoughts?
No, this is not a strong budget. It hurts a lot of people. It takes away percentages of payouts to Medicaid, Medicare, veterans, disabilities.
You're saying the Republicans are trying to cut those programs like Social Security
they're not trying to cut them. They're trying to cut back on them. They are trying to cut back on them. But, you know, we're still trying to pay the bills from the Trump administration. That's how the debt ceiling works. That's how debt works.
So that explains why the last couple of years may have been rough, is because we're still cleaning up Trump's mess.
Per se, yes. Yes. Yeah. But the problem, think about this, Zeus, because right now they are estimating that because of the low revenues and taxes, when they signed their tax plan in 2017, when Donald Trump signed that tax plan, he basically
jumped right down the throats of Americans' mouths. He did.
Pretty much. And he basically killed $3 trillion in revenue of tax money from the top 1% of the country, or the wealthiest part of the country. So $3 trillion worth of revenue is gone. Our debt ceiling, we were not expected to hit our limit until July. Now they're estimating that, because, you know, tax day was a few weeks ago, they're estimating that we're going to hit that limit in June. And all the Republicans want to do, instead of putting those tax policies back in place for the ultra wealthy and the wealthy, you know, people like Donald Trump, they want to do things like part of their budget proposal. If you're on Medicaid or Medicare,
this is truth, ladies and gentlemen. He's not lying. Get your ink pads and notepads out. Take notes.
You can easily go and look these things up. One of the things that they want to do, if you are on Medicaid and Medicare, they want you to work at least 80 hours a month, right? Mm-hmm. Or not 80 hours a month. I think it was 40 hours a month. Basically part time. But how can you tell someone with physical hardships, the reason that they're on Medicaid and Medicare is because they have physical hardships that they can't work? But you want to make them go to work to give them the benefits that they've already earned and have been getting.
You know, Swervin, I'm just getting, you know, everything you're saying, I know it's 100% true. And I'm just wondering, what does the Republican Party have to say about all of this?
Dude, I have no idea. They won't say anything about it. And this is why, you know, we've heard a lot of people say they are playing Russian roulette with the debt ceiling, right? Now, if we go back into Donald Trump's presidency, I can't even believe I have to put those words together. But if we go back into his presidency, Republicans and Democrats came together three times. There was no negotiation. It was basically like everybody said, okay, raise it, because it's the only way we're going to get ourselves
Pandemic. Hold on one second. I got to say something. So I see there are some comments about using the word reporting in the comments. I just wanted to let all of you know there's zero tolerance for that, and you will be blocked. It's just the right thing to do. If this live just doesn't fit what you would like, you don't enjoy the entertainment and the politics, you know, you can go on. And, you know, I know of a lot of other content creators who they don't share this same perspective, and they're more than willing to keep you believing what you're believing. But over here, you know, just come on in and listen. If you want to talk, we can talk, but no need to get upset about the truth. All right, Swervin, please continue.
I'm going to say this. You in the claws of the truth, where only one man wields the hammer of truth.
Facts.
So, but if we go back into the Donald Trump presidency, like I said, three times they raised the debt ceiling. There was no negotiation. Even when Democrats held the Congress, there was no negotiation. Nobody said, hey, you're going to do this or else. There was none of that. And I will use my friend named Jennifer.
Okay.
May she rest in peace. Mm-hmm. Jennifer had cerebral palsy. There was no way she could work. Her body was so constricted. There was no way she could work. But people like Jennifer, they want to take away parts of her Medicaid and Medicare. And that then takes Jennifer's mother and makes Jennifer's mother have to get a second job just to try to make ends meet and meet those medical costs.
Right.
This is where our Republican Party is right now. Mm. They are the party of no ideas. And Zeus, let me give you a quick breakdown as to how politics work.
Okay. And if there are some members on the right that would love to get in the box and talk, we definitely can. You know, we just don't call each other names and stuff. We just talk about the issue. If there's something you disagree with, point it out.
Zeus, yes. I want to ask your permission.
Yes.
In order to help drive this point home, I do need to use one cuss word. Just one. So when you are in the Congress, you have somebody who will stand up on the left or the right and they say, hey, I got a really bad idea. Mm-hmm. And then somebody on the other side of the aisle will go, they will stand up and they will go, I can make it even shittier.
Oh, Mervin, where's my sound effect?
I'm just saying. I asked.
Yeah. Keep it clean.
I'm doing pretty good so far.
Yeah, you're doing good.
That's the way our politics works. People come up with bad ideas, and then other people will look at those same ideas and they will try to figure out a way to make it better for them, which is going to make it crappier for someone else. Mm. And that's how our politics works. Right now, this game of Russian roulette that we're playing with the debt ceiling, it could be devastating. Not just to America. If America defaults on its debt, it will not only be devastating to America, it will be devastating to the entire world.
I agree.
Markets will crash all over the planet.
Mm, I agree. So why would the members of the Republican Party want that to happen? Anyone out there, please answer.
They currently have no ideas to do anything. They have nothing. Oh. You know, when I spoke to you this morning about Zoe Zephyr.
Yeah.
They passed a law banning gender affirming care.
Hmm.
That's their big idea. We're going to end up hurting people in their medical care. We're going to make the decisions. We're going to sit here. Politicians are now going to make healthcare decisions for people. That is ridiculous. That is absolutely ridiculous. But you know what? You know what? Zeus, imagine if a woman came out and passed a bill that said, we're going to ban Viagra. Do you know how quick these fools would lose their mind?
They would definitely lose it. But you know what? If a woman did do it, you know what? Ban it. Get it out of here if it's going to save lives. That's how I feel.
And I don't know. They will talk about, well, that's God's will when it comes to that life banning that woman.
Mike,
that's God's will.
Viagra. Mike, you do use it. You know you do. Anyone that says they don't use it, they use it.
Zeus, I'm gonna tell you like this: when they say that fetus being alive, that's a child. That's God's will. You know what? So is a limp Peter. That's God's will. So just deal with it. We just got too much going on. We got the debt ceiling thing going on. We got E. Jean Carroll started out her testimony. Donald Trump graced me. And I'm like,
I'm still laughing at the God's will of the limp thing. Okay.
Well,
don't be out there popping that blue pill and blue dolphins, folks. Cut it out.
Yeah. Yeah. There are actually commercials that run on television. Here's how you can get Viagra for 37 cents a pill, as opposed to, I'm like, what are we looking at here? These are the commercials y'all running.
Say it as it's so.
If
there's a gentleman out here who would like to say that's not true and you want to confess about your Viagra, you know, please feel free to send a guest request. I would love to help you get to the bottom of what's really going on. Because I hear that, you know, all you got to do is quit watching, you know, Donald J. Trump and you'll get your mojo back.
Let's look. They can look at Big Hurt. You know who Big Hurt is, right? Big Hurt?
No, what is Big Hurt?
Big Hurt, Frank Thomas.
Oh, yeah.
And he does them NuGenics commercials. For low testosterone. You can go get some of that.
Yeah, I've seen him.
Yeah, let him go get some of that. But Zeus, do you know?
I'm not a doctor. Don't take my advice. Don't take Swervin's advice. These are just, you know, opinions.
Zeus, did you know that the insurance companies are billed almost $50 million a year for Viagra?
I had no clue.
The federal government spent almost as much for it.
Are they blaming? Are they saying that they don't want to put this stuff in their body because, you know, during the COVID, you know how people were getting very sensitive about getting those, you know, what do you call them? I don't want to say it on TikTok, but you know, they didn't want to get that. They call it the jab. Yeah, they didn't want to get the jabby jab, but you telling me they want to go pop those blue dolphins?
Yeah. And you know what's even funny about the jabby jab? They sit here and they, oh, I ain't getting that thing. You don't even know what's in it.
Yeah.
But not one single time did any of them question the McRib that they were shoveling into their face. They never said anything about that Monster Energy
fast food.
They never said nothing about that Chipotle. They never said nothing about that. Not a single one of them ever woke up going, you know what? Zeus, I don't know about you, but I woke up this morning and I really want to know why I don't have measles, mumps, rubella, typhoid fever, or cholera, or any of these other things. I wonder why I don't have any of that. Zeus, you ever wonder about that?
I know why, because I go to my doctor and I take the recommendations very seriously.
Okay? Exactly.
And, you know, we all have been vaccinated at one point in our life. You know, even the dogs do it. Even the dogs do it. You get a new puppy, you got to take them to get his shots. Take him or her to go get their shots. It's normal. I get there's concern. I totally get that. But it's the hypocrisy that gets me. You want, on one side, you're over there popping them things, okay? And then I'm talking to the men that are popping them things out here and going out and acting like they're still in their 20s when they know they're in their 60s. Cut it out. It's over. It's over.
I love the side effects. I remember when that stuff first came out and I'm looking at these commercials talking about the side effects. If you have an erection that lasts longer than 4 hours, seek medical help. I was like, I'm not seeking medical help. I'm picking up the phone.
Yeah.
I'm gonna see if I can get some women over here or something. I don't know. Maybe even call my boys up just to brag about it.
Lord have mercy.
Maybe even call up my boys just to brag about it, dude. Y'all not gonna believe this. Listen, we going on 5 hours.
You better get some ice and pour it on yourself, sir.
You start thinking to yourself.
All right, I gotta cut it out. That's TMI. I get it.
You start thinking to yourself, Margaret Thatcher naked on a cold day. Margaret Thatcher naked on a cold day. And that might not help. But Zeus, let me tell you this.
God. There's a couple people I do need to bring up, you know, Swervin. So.
No, I get it, man. I understand. I'm going to be brief.
But you did warm the closet up. I always appreciate these candid discussions of honesty. You know, it could be politics. It could be cooking. It could be that those blue things that you were just. It don't matter. The truth got to get out there.
I'm gonna tell you this, and then I'm gonna go ahead and drop myself down. My younger brother Christopher, when he was 6 months old, he got his MMR vaccine.
Oh,
and when that MMR vaccine ran through his brain, it severely scarred his brain.
Mm.
That's what it did to him, and it left him mentally handicapped for the rest of his life.
Wow!
And he lived to the age of 30, which was almost 10 years ago to the day. Right.
Mm. Right.
And the doctors told my mother, they said this could have happened to 1 in 350,000. Christopher, unfortunately, was at 1. And what we woke up to a few hours after he got this vaccine, he was only 6 months old, so he was still in the crib. And what we woke up to, Zeus, was this noise. And he was having such a seizure, that was his crib hitting the wall in his bedroom.
Wow. Right? Yeah.
And so I asked my mother, even to this day, in fact, I just asked her a few months ago, because we're coming up on the anniversary of his passing. And I asked her, I said, knowing what you know about Chris, would you still have let him get that vaccine? And she said, yes. Because it was the right thing to do to not only protect him, protect you all, and protect other children that he was in school with. And that's where...
That's a mother's... You know, mothers, when they say stuff, it carries a lot of weight because, you know, they have a bond with their children like no one else.
Exactly.
So for her to say that, that means a lot.
And she still firmly believes that to this day. You know, his And Chris was, I remember being at his funeral, and the pastor spoke about Christopher as one of God's touched children. And I said, when it was my turn to get up and speak, I completely had to change my speech after I heard that. And I got up and I spoke and I said, look at all the people that are here right now.
Right.
I don't think God touched Christopher. I think people like Christopher refer to as God's touch children. Because look at all the lives he touched while he was here. Look at everybody around in here right now.
Amen.
He touched every single one of us in a special way.
That's right. There's no limit to the power of God's awesomeness. Cut it out, folks.
And that was beautiful to me.
Yeah. You know?
And I just remember that day, his funeral, helping my mother pick out his clothes and the casket, you know, and stuff like that. And just want people to understand, because right now, and I'm going to bring it back to politics now. This is what we call coming full circle.
Okay, bring it back.
I'm going to bring it back to politics right now, because right now you have Republican legislatures that are trying to pass bills that says it's okay to physically beat disabled children in school. You have these things being passed or being written, and if you're not paying attention to that and you agree with that, then you, man, woman, whoever you are, listen to the sound of my voice, you are a fascist, because you are supporting a party with fascist ideology and fascist ideals. Simple. And with that being said, Brother Zeus, always a pleasure being up on Mount Olympus with you.
Yeah.
You keep wielding that hammer of truth.
I shall.
You keep the lights on in the closet of truth.
I will.
If people are willing to receive the information, then hopefully they can go and look up the information for their own, and they can educate themselves. But more importantly, they're going to learn something. And learning should be an ongoing process our entire lives.
I completely agree. Learning is never ending. You must always present yourself as a student in order to increase your knowledge and then become a master like Zeus and Swervin.
My friend.
All right.
You take care, brother. You be safe and you keep holding it down like a champ. All right.
I will and I shall. And you as well. Thank you.
Take care, Zeus.
You're welcome. Thank you. Oh, yes. Wow. What a great conversation with my good friend Swervin. You know what side of the aisle Swervin is on. And that's okay. Okay. We all can pick and choose which side we want to be on. That's totally fine. But like I said, I'm not with any of the kid games. You know, I used to have more patience to deal with people yelling and cursing at me. But at this point, ladies and gentlemen, I got too many things going on. I can't handle it. It's either we can talk or we can't. Next. We either can talk or we can't. Next. You know what I mean? Okay, ladies and gentlemen. Greetings, Brother Greg.
What up, Brian?
Yeah. What up going on? I haven't heard from you in a few days.
Yeah, I was sick. I was sick for a couple of days. I got a nasty stomach bug.
That's not true, Lynn. I can handle whatever I can handle, okay? Yes.
Yeah, I had a nasty stomach bug for a couple days.
Oh, wow.
It had me sidelined. So
that's all
I wasn't here for.
Well, health is well. I hope you're taking the right steps to protect your health, sir.
Yeah, no, I think I'm okay, but it was pretty scary. I passed out and everything, so it's pretty wild.
So are you up and up? Are you taking some Pedialyte and stuff like that? You know, I hear that stuff does help.
Yeah, I've been, you know, keeping hydrated, trying to get back to eating solid food. But
good. Yeah, you always have to stay hydrated and make sure you're eating when you're not feeling well. So I appreciate you taking time, you know, all this is going on to come check on your good friend Zeus out here in Olympus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so the friends in the chat seem to want to know what bill numbers are. So
They're free to, if you want bill numbers, it's very simple. Just look them up. They're all on Google. I would tell you, but I've been branded as a liar, a terrible person. So I don't think I can help you on that. But if you have a bill number, please feel free to put it in the comments.
Also Felix, interestingly, has some things where he has been saying that he wants to, quote, come at me. So I don't know what that means.
Felix? I don't know.
Yeah, he's been very adamant about this.
Felix is just joking. I don't think Felix.
Yeah, bring it. I don't know.
Father, forgive Felix, for he knows not what he says or does. Okay, Felix, please cut it out. And you need to work on maintaining that great relationship with your wife, Felix. Okay, make sure you're spending a lot of time with her.
Yeah. So the thing is here that I believe that the
attacking.
The president is going to veto that sailing bill.
You think so? Yeah. I heard it was a good bill. I thought Kevin McCarthy put a lot of work into it. You know, he's cutting programs that, you know, people need, but to him, he doesn't care. So he says he has the votes.
Yeah, but it seems like the cuts to the veterans and stuff like that might be a little too much.
You hear that, Felix? Cuts to the veterans. Wow. You hear that, conservative win? You hear that? This is what we're talking about, okay?
Yeah, so that's at least what I've heard. Now, if they can't get a deal done, then I guess they might, but it has to go through the Senate, right? So I don't think it's going to even pass there. So
it's just a waste of time. Say my name, Conservative Lynn. You know I like saying your name. Cut it out. But yeah, you bring those docket numbers. Okay, so you think the Senate is going to shut it down? You think Biden is going to shut it down? You think they're going to be back?
I think the Senate might just make it easier for him and not do it, like not have to deal with it.
Shame. But why would they want to take away the programs that they know the people need? Why would they do it? They lifted the debt ceiling for Trump. Why won't they do it for Biden?
Well, because that's what they do. I mean, they think we can't read between the lines, like Swerman said. They're like, where in the bill does it say this? Or I need docket numbers, or I need this. It's like, dude, we know. We can read. We know what they're going for. Mm. Just because it doesn't say it directly, we know exactly what they're looking to do.
Exactly. We know what they're trying to do. You're trying to destroy the country and blame it on the Democrats. Oldest trick in the book.
Yeah. But yeah, like attacking said, 22% cut for families, seniors, and vets. That's what it looks like right now, and that's why.
Thumbs down.
It's not good. It's not good at all.
Yeah. Are you following this case up there in New York with the former president? What do you think of that?
Well, as I've said many times, I think that is connected to Weiselberg. And say, oh, you're conspiracy theorist.
You're connecting. But how's that connected to Weiselberg?
I just think that the taxes and stuff are connected somehow.
Mm.
That's just my personal view. Because Because everybody's saying, like, where's the felony charge? Well, it could be from that one.
No, I'm talking about the E. Jean Carroll one.
Oh, the E. Jean Carroll
one. Yeah. I'm so sorry. Yeah, because, you know, I said earlier, my brain was scrambled when I read her opening statement. You know, she came out today and she said, I am here because I was raped by Donald Trump. What a way to start a trial, right?
Right. Yeah. And I mean,
if I were a Trump supporter and I voted for this, I would be like, you know what? I can't do anything with that guy. It's over.
I'll be honest. I haven't been following it as closely, probably because I've just been under the weather. But, you know, I just know that it's a civil case. She's trying to collect damages. And
slander,
you know. It's always slander. It's always slander with them, you know.
Don't you trust women, conservative Lynn? You don't trust women? Come on now.
Somebody's saying this isn't Greg. How? What do you mean this isn't Greg?
What? you're softly. You're in a the Twilight Zone, sir. You're not who you are. No, well, not one looking for money in a. Come on, Lynn. Would you go out in front of the world and ask for money like this? Perhaps
somebody asked what was wrong with my car. Yeah, on Friday my car broke down too, so I had a rough time there. Yeah, my car. Wow. They don't really know what happened. They said the oil was low and I could have shut it off. Mm. So that's all that I got out of it. So, you know. But they need me to do the Trump impression, I guess, to make sure it's me.
Oh, they said you are just an AI bot.
I don't know what's going on today. Why does everybody think I'm not the real Greg? What is this, Eminem? Who am
Will I, Eminem? Will Wilson Shady, please stand up. Dave Wilson, hope that Lake Merritt water is treating you well. Maybe is there anything you can do to show us that it's really the real Greg and not...
Well, we're doing so great. We're doing so great, please. Everybody's doing so strong. If you look at all the people that are doing great things.
Oh, the real Slim is here. Oh, yes. The real Slim is here. Shady.
Yeah. It's me. It's me. It's me. Hi. I don't really have anything to add today because I don't, like I said, if you're talking about Eugene, I don't really have enough. But I was here in case some people wanted to, like Felix wanted to talk to me about something, but I don't really know what he wanted to talk to me about, to be honest. And also make me a mod, because when you have people like Girth Brooks who are emotional and they're going to report you, it's just easier to have me report or just get rid of them.
Oh, okay. Well, I will have to deal with that then, but you might want to check your situation now. You might already have those powers.
Oh, I might.
You might, you know, because it's sort of like how Trump can classify and declassify documents.
Oh, yeah, it looks like I am.
I can just think it. I can just think it, and it's done.
Well, it's so strong. It's so strong. We're so excited for you.
And by the way, you know, president has all kinds of powers. He can take whatever he wants and do whatever he wants, right?
Oh, yeah, without any repercussions.
It's no, great. It's a witch hunt.
It's always a witch hunt, but it's just, you know, deflect, deny. And what's the third one? Dodgeball. Alvin Bragg. But yeah, I'll drop out right now because I'm at work, so I can't really talk that much.
Okay,
thank
you.
I appreciate you.
I appreciate you, and thank you for checking in, you know. Bye. Oh, you like witch hunts.
If you're on, like when I'm off work, I can talk, you know,
more. That's, and louder. Well, I tried not to be on during the afternoon shift. Because I think the other content creators out there that are carrying the message are doing just fine, you know. So I wake up bright and early, and I get the Trump crowd going. Hey, listen, over here we have receipts. Okay, we're not gonna let Trump sneak in that White House again, and they know it.
Oh, they know it.
They know it. Yeah, they didn't back in, and they know they're in trouble. Mm.
Well, Zeus, I will talk to you later, buddy.
All right. Thank you, sir.
All right. See you.
Yes. 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 Oh, my goodness, ladies and gentlemen. See, as you can see, you know, we are, you know, dealing with a lot in the kingdom. Oh, Yes, feel better, Greg. Greetings, Brother Red. Yes. You want like to talk with Zeus.
Yeah, I got some conspiracies with some proof that I want to address with you.
Oh.
This is before we get to the Biden crime family, I want to address the first conspiracy.
Okay.
Your goatee is fraudulent.
That's fair.
I think if you pull it, it'll come right off.
You know, don't do that. Don't do that. Because listen, Brother Red, with all due respect, it's not the goatee that makes the man. It is the man that makes the goatee.
You know, I knew it. You hear that? Me. He admitted it. He made it.
You know what they call me here, sir? Go ahead and say it. Triple H, okay?
Nobody calls him that.
Why do they call me Triple H, Greg? Go ahead, say it with me. Because I am honest, yes. Am I honest, Red? Am I the most honest person on TikTok that you know?
I think that you believe that you're honest.
Next. Humble. I am the most humble person on TikTok, Red. And you know it. A lot of your friends know it. And
last, I can't address that.
And last but not least, Red, I am the most handsome man on this platform.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Now go ahead and give yourself a pat on the back for trying, okay? But, you know, you just didn't do it. And there's many, many people come to the kingdom every day. Hello, Triple H. Hello, you're the most handsome. You see it.
No, I've never seen that.
I've never seen anybody do such things for you. No, as a matter of fact. Thank you, Little Miss Perfect. As a matter of fact, if you go listen to the song, Zeus, it opens. Zeus opens, the most handsome in the kingdom. What more evidence do you need? Don't worry about that stuff, sir. So that conspiracy that you thought was a conspiracy, no, it's true. What you got next?
All right, so now we gotta get to it.
They're saying Zeus is handsome. So what do you got next for us?
That person whose picture is that can't be that doesn't track, sorry. But so let's get back to the Biden crime family.
If you Red, be honest, you know, if you were of the opposite sex, you would definitely be looking twice at Zeus three or four times, wouldn't you?
I'm looking three or four times now to try to figure out what it is that I'm looking at.
Keep on looking.
All right. We got to get to the Biden crime syndicate, though. Figure out what's going on with your boy and why is his family being subpoenaed and indicted? This is unprecedented.
Well, so are you talking about Hunter Biden?
All of them. We need the receipts. Where are the receipts?
Yeah. Now, you know the rule. You have a docket number.
The doc, you want me to give you the docket number? Absolutely. for Joe or Hunter?
Both, because you know I would give it to you, but I've been told I'm a liar and I can't be trusted. So I'm hoping.
Well, I thought you were the most honest and humble.
Well, out of your mouth, sir, comes the truth, and thank you. You're right, I am. But you know, to those that don't know what you and I have been saying, like they don't believe us. So it have to come from you. So can you please go ahead and share with us that docket number?
I don't have a docket number. I just have the screenshot here from House.gov saying that they're being subpoenaed one by one. Mm. But of course we obviously can't arrest the sitting president. So I was wondering, are you guys gonna put up Kamala? What are you guys gonna do for 2024?
So what you said, House.gov, can you go ahead and give me that? Hold on, let me get my extra special notepad over here, okay? The truth notepad. Okay, now what exactly is that docket number, sir?
So you just type in Biden indictment, okay. And the first thing that's going to come up, you think that would be on your 30 news stations that you guys on.
Yeah, hold on. Let me
You think CNN or NBC could cover that?
Hold on. Biden indictment. Okay, let's see what the good old internet has. Oh, wait a second. Hold on. It says there's no internet connection. Nope. Let me double check.
Hold on. How convenient. Somebody on the internet has no internet connection. Look at this.
Yeah. Okay. Hold I mean, you know, I don't want to say you're pulling my leg, but Zeus got to check it out. Now I think I'm connected now. Hold on. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Come on, give me what? How Biden? Okay, so it has a political article, NBC
Yeah, that
News.
sounds could be great.
I don't necessarily see anything.
House.gov is the one that's house.gov from the White House.
Yeah, it's not showing up.
Oh, let me put it up for you here. I'll make it my background for you here.
I see white. Okay, remarked by
Oh,
President
now I can find it.
Biden. Remarked by President Biden before Marine One departure.
No. Here, I'll put it up for you.
Technical difficulties. It seems that there is an internet connection issue with Red, and so that's two. That two conspiracies he's brought to the kingdom that I've debunked. Okay,
I'm right
before the
here. I'm just changing my background so you can see
Oh.
it.
Oh,
Since
okay.
your internet isn't working. Let me move my head for you. That's right there for you. Would you like to read the rest? I don't know
Hold
why
on, hold
Democrats can't find that. You must be on that Democratic internet.
You know that's not necessarily what I think it is. I just can't quite read it.
Hey, let's make it even more. That looks bad on that. Let me see if I can make
It
it better.
looks like it's in a
I have
different
to send it
language.
to
Okay, it looks
you. I
like
mean,
it's
it's
in
on
a different.
house.gov.
Okay. All right. All right. Well, you know what, Brother Red? I'm going to have to say, you know what? You're going to at least get an a B for effort. Okay. You're going to get a B for effort. Okay. But.
I think the letter you're looking for is S.
And what exactly would the S stand for?
Super, superb, spectacular, stunning. I'm running out of S words here.
Hello, Yazzie. Yes, it is I, Triple H. So it
I'm
looks
gonna
like,
drop down.
from my assessment of that, it looks as if, oh, he left. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know why he left, but I hope, Christine, I love you too. I hope that he left because he woke up and he realized that I'm telling why I did it. In this case, he was very respectful. He came in very respectful. Don't call him a name or nothing. He was very respectful, and he thought he knew something. But he got in the box. He thought he had me on my handsomeness. He tried to talk about the goatee. Only found out I was 10 times more handsome than he realized. I opened up his eyes. You should have seen his eye. His mind woke up. He's woke now. And then he brought in he brought in the information that he felt was going to prove that Biden had indictments. I looked at the page and I trust that that source he provided is accurate, but I didn't see a docket number. As far as I was concerned, it looked like it was in a different language. It looked like maybe it was in Arabic. I'm not really versed in Arabic, but I know the swirls and the squiggly lines, and I think that's what it was. And I'm not good at that, so hopefully he can come back one of these days with that information. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Zeus does have to run. Okay, I know. I didn't get to talk to everyone, but I appreciated this time in the closet of truth, and I do hope that we got to the bottom of a lot of misinformation out here. I will be back tomorrow, bright and early. All right. Until next time. And by the way, Rick, thank you for subscribing and renewing your membership. You will get access to more special prizes. Okay. Dave Wilson, stay away from that Lake Merritt water. Okay. It's not going to help you, sir. And last but not least, ladies and gentlemen, you know what it is. Trump supporters, get those knee pads ready, 'cause Jack Smith is coming.